Chúng ta chúng rếp chung thả. Cá chạp đám đôi đời thêm bàn bà chết. Cá chạp đám khi nhóm thơ tại mũi đi. Còn ta ấy lấy khi nhóm trời thơ mà rồi.
Tiếp thế này.
Bà đôi chứ nó. Còn nạp bạc bà chỉ chuẩn miền hà sớm mũi cả ấy. Ai giờ đòm yên vô lý. Miền pram cả ấy. Ai giờ đòm Prum nè kể rì miền mũi cả ấy. Dương miền bạc xâm quán. Bà đập hiếp miền hà sớm bà cả ấy. Bộ nâng đọc pi, đại tranh thế này đi, chẳng ta đọc pi, đại bạc cát ngày đi. Cứ viên lớp pi ca chạm bạch nây ha sắp bộ mùi. Nây chia chậm nói tì mùi. Đại sầm lên khăn ông sập hía, cứ bắt con chi ngay, phiên con chỉ chi ngay. Bạc sầm con là phía bốc chìa mùi nâng nặng, chẳng ta cá, cứ bắt con chi lơ khăn ông chậm nói ha sắp bộ mùi. Dương khăn ông nâng chui công trô khang này nì vô bạc. Nó cứ kháng phá chất nâng xe mặt đấy. Rập tên dược trong chuối phá đó. Nơi bảo quản khô xe nạ ai phát. Bảo quản khô xe nạ. Đại miên xe mặt này chất chưa mùi hôn phèn. Cứ cổng hôn ai cái chuẩn. Cả xe ai cái chuẩn. Ai nâng chuối đó. Cổng rồi bỏ ai làm tuân trải. Bảo xâm miên xâm nông bò. Dương khiêm nâng chuối kháng hê rành vật thổ. Tạm lắc tập hiếp để ai thư cả. Ngay mần mần chứ ca chứa chứa đấy. Cái ca tây khăn ông rồi bỏ nè nà tặng ơ. Tại vì chứa sức rồi bỏ dương chồng. Hỏi lùi ní lùi bàn mau bì lùi lộ cả cha.
Cái ca tặng ơ để tạm. Chúng tạm đàn cả lòng máu. Xâm đách bật thiên chứa xịt. Cả nạ bạc bật chứa chún. Lúc thả lúc mần bá. Điệp trong bành hà này tì. Để chết chồng bách ní. Nhưng xâm đá ưu tê đê mà nốt mần nhẹ. Để tên tệ bọc co phải nhá. Mình chốt mình chô. Nơi lưu sẽ gặp một hiếp rồi bọc luôn. Cả cầm riêng cầm hay một phật một phi. Tinh tức chất. Tinh mình ban. Sầm lắp ấy đi. Cứ miên tên một lúc mình đã cốt. Cứ sầm đách đi dụ ở rốt mình trái tì phì hôn sạc. Cả
lúc
mùa thiên. Chỉ nên ở
rốt phân cân nguyên bản đấy. Nó chỉ cả
phật. It is quite true. What evidence do you have?
Nên phỏng đàn đấy rồi.
Nhi ai cái xa tặng mà. Ai cái xa tìm mối. Lúc mong rồi thi khuôn ấy. Mình men quạt lũ cao su từ oi lũ dung xa ra thế. Mà nơi ta quạt. Dung xa ra nó chịp thân này mùi. Nẹ rột ca rồi bọc rộng hôn quạt. Quạt chặt tăng nẹ nâng ấy rột ca. Còn phần tay khăn ông cao su kẹt nâng. Vì mình cái xa nó không nâng chẳng. Bắt cao su bị lớn. Ai cái xa này cứ mình càng ca bật tèm côi. Côi để tránh bị khlang rồi bỏ mong rồi thì nâu bởi ấy. Có côi kia tự tuôn thả. Kia tèm rồi bỏ kia đánh. Xin để bật. Nhìn lắm mà. Xin để bật công khí nơ này mùi như mùi lắm. Vì mình nó không đi tăng óc cho mình chút ai cái xa này bỏ tăng óc mà. Mình tăng bị phát khinh đi. Giao dụng đi. Kinh vôi. Và hãy nâng ca trụ kỳ nất. Cả bóng phân, rồi bóng rộng phân mong rồi thi. Nó lơ. Ai cái xa tặng ốc, miền hạt đề lê kha, miền ấy cực loan tặng ốc. Và đối chứ mình mến chìa ca khai bằng lòng đôi quạt tha tê. Quạt chìa nẹ khai bằng lòng ai cái xa cởi bìl chạp. Chắc
lòng
mặt chạp đôi
mong rồi thi.
Bà nhà hát cứ đôi chung chung riêng chẳng mà. Bởi chạp mong rồi thi, bìl nụ. Xâm đạch đi dụ ở rạp mình trầy phân xe. Quạt bán bảo ca nặng nông tu rồi tu. Thả bờ hô sốc trong từ chập mông rồi thí. Ôi bẹt các bà biết đại tàu thỏng. Đấy chứ nế, thầm mây ní. Đại quạt trái lời bằng viên thả. Pi công thầy nơ rồi quạt xam sập bằng bay tòn buồn rồi ní. Quạt tàu mà lê dí thế. Đấy chứ khang mê lê dí mà lê dí. Bồ lý ông trả chiếc mà lê dí kê phạm mọc trong vinh. Thả khám miên khơi pi công thầy nơ rồi bọc mông rồi thí tàu mà lê dí thế. Ôt miên. Đấy chứ miên tại pi công thầy nơ tàu xảy làng cá. Cứ cảnh tra pi công thầy nơ ní. Nếu quát phải chỉ truyền sạp hết bà thầm mấy ní xã rốt ảm rịch. Bạn đặt lực lý chấm phúc ọc nhà thêm bên mạng. Mình ở chỗ xã rốt ảm rịch. Đời xa bẹp quán đường đường này thầy. Đấy chứ cồm tầng ọc ní. Cứ chứ cồm nâu chung vinh xâm bạch hồn xe.
Without objection, the motion to reconsider is laid on the table.
Madam Speaker.
Gentleman from New York.
I move that the House suspend rules, agree to House Resolution 533 as amended.
Clerk will report the title of the bill.
House Resolution 533, resolution expressing the sense of the House of Representatives regarding the culpability of Hun Sen for war crimes, crimes against humanity, and genocide in Cambodia, the former Kampuchea, the People's Republic of Kampuchea, and the State of Cambodia.
Pursuant to the rule, the gentleman from New York, Mr. Gilman, and the gentleman from Florida, Mr. Davis, each will control 20 minutes. The chair recognizes the gentleman from New York.
Thank you, Madam Speaker, and I yield myself such time as I may consent.
Gentleman is recognized.
Consent, revise, and extend my remarks. All members may have 5 days within which to revise and extend their remarks.
Without objection.
Madam Speaker, I rise today in support of H.R.S. 533, expressing the sense of the House of Representatives regarding the culpability of Hun Sen for his violations of international humanitarian law after 1978 in Cambodia. And I want to commend the gentleman from California, member of our International Relations Committee, Mr. Rohrabacher, for introducing this resolution condemning Hun Sen's violent transgressions in Cambodia over the past 20 years. Mr. Rohrabacher, we thank you for your outstanding leadership on this issue. I also want to thank the gentleman from Nebraska, the chairman of the Asia-Pacific Subcommittee, Mr. B. Ryder, for his work on this important measure and for his continuing attention to the crisis in Cambodia. I'm a proud co-sponsor of this resolution, which I support fully. It is incredibly important that this House express its concern about the violence that has and continues to plague Cambodia and make every effort to bring those responsible for this unnecessary violence to justice. If tyranny, and especially tyrants like Hun Sen, are allowed to thrive in an atmosphere of impunity, and violence and destruction will reign not only in Cambodia, but elsewhere as well. Our nation must make a strong stand and take action to bring this senseless killing to an end and to punish those who are responsible. But before I close, I want to express my general concern about the situation in Cambodia and the pervasive high levels of violence that exists there. The extrajudicial violence must come to an end. Our nation must use its influence and leverage to pressure any government which is formed to move in a direction of democracy and its respect for human rights. The administration must also seek to garner support from other key nations such as France, Australia, and Japan to do the same. The Cambodian people deserve as much, and the international community should accept no less. Though I never believed that the most recent elections could ever be free and fair because of the environment in which they took place, the tremendous turnout by the Cambodian voters shows that the seeds of democracy have been sown there. It's my belief that any tyrant who tries to stand between democracy and human rights and the Cambodian people will ultimately find himself resigned to the trash heap of history, as have so many other despots who've tried to suppress the human spirit. To the forces of democracy in Cambodia, we in this body are watching carefully. You can be assured that the Cambodian people will not stand alone in your quest for democracy, for justice, for human rights, for peace and freedom. This resolution sends that kind of signal. Accordingly, I urge my colleagues to support this measure, and I reserve the balance of my time.
Gentleman reserves the balance of his time. The gentleman from Florida.
Thank you, Madam Speaker. I rise in support of this resolution and yield myself such time as I may
consume. Gentleman is recognized.
I'd like to start by commending the gentleman from California, Mr. Rohrabacher, for his leadership in bringing the resolution before the House today. Also appreciate his willingness to work with members of the administration and concerns of members of the House. House Resolution 533 is intended to send a clear signal to Hun Sen and his supporters that the United States and the entire international community views with grave concerns both his past actions and his current activities threaten to impose a system of harsh dictatorship on the people of Cambodia. There are few people who, through no fault of their own, have suffered more cruelly in the last past quarter century than the Cambodians. In the aftermath of a badly flawed election, Hun Sen is in the process of solidifying his holds of the levers of power in Cambodia. And in the final analysis, I regret to say there is little the United States can do to prevent this tragedy. But at an absolute minimum, we must make clear our opposition to the imposition of a repressive regime upon the long-suffering Cambodian people. We can unequivocally as well state our conviction that those responsible for Cambodia's past sorrows should be brought to justice. And so, Madam Speaker, this resolution deserves our support. I urge my colleagues to join me in voting yes on this important measure, and I reserve the balance of my time.
The gentleman reserves the balance of his time. The gentleman from New York.
Madam Speaker, I'm pleased to yield 5 minutes to the sponsor of this resolution, a gentleman from California, a member of our committee, Mr. Rohrbacher. The
gentleman from California is recognized for 5 minutes.
Madam Speaker, House Resolution 533 is intended to help support democracy in Cambodia and prevent a new killing field by serving as the first step to bringing the violent dictator and former Pol Pot trigger man Hun Sen to justice. This legislation urges the United States government and other interested countries to create an appropriate international judicial tribunal for the indictment and trial of Hun Sen. For the past 20 years, since he was among a core group of former Khmer Rouge officials installed as leaders during the Vietnamese communist occupation of Cambodia, Hun Sen has been at the center of massive violations of international human rights law, including murder, torture, and other widespread abuses of the Cambodian people. During the past month, Hun Sen's stormtroopers have cracked down on nonviolent pro-democracy demonstrators, including students and Buddhist monks and tens of thousands of ordinary people. There are numerous reports by United Nations human rights monitors describing shallow graves containing mutilated bodies with hands tied behind their backs, including some people who are known to have been arrested by Hun Sen's security forces. Bodies of other victims have been reportedly seen floating down rivers and streams. Buddhist temples and monasteries have been raided, and monks whipped by soldiers and goons carrying electric batons and rifle butts. Amnesty International reports that at least 200 democracy protesters arrested are still unaccounted for. New atrocities continue to emerge. For example, United Nations human rights monitors have been sheltering a 25-year-old woman who was held by Hun Sen's soldiers for 3 weeks in a water-filled fish pen. She saw five of 13 fellow prisoners die during that time period from torture, starvation, and drowning, including Buddhist monks. During the 1998 election campaign in Cambodia, the United States International Republican Institute, as well as the National Democratic Institute, reported widespread incidents of violence, intimidation, and deaths of campaigners for the Democratic parties who opposed Hun Sen. The electoral process was described as, quote, fundamentally flawed, end of quote. Post-election charges of irregularities in ballot counting and an unconstitutional allocation of parliamentary seats led to the pro-democracy uprising and a subsequent repression in Phnom Penh. Many of these pro-democracy demonstrators courageously defied Hun Sen's stormtroopers, and they were carrying American flags and broadcast by Voice of America, in which they were playing for the rest of the people there through loudspeakers in this short-lived democracy square. The fear, intimidation, and violence created by Hun Sen continues. Yesterday, an American investigative reporter named Nate Thayer, he's the one who broke the story of Pol Pot's death and also the relationship between Hun Sen and reputed international drug dealer Teng Munma, informed me that his wife, Carol, an American citizen, had been assaulted. That's Nate Thayer, an American citizen, a journalist in Cambodia. His wife has been assaulted, and in fact, a bullet was fired during the assault that grazed her head. This all happened in central Phnom Penh. Nate and Carol have been previously received 4 death threats due to his reporting on corruption and tyranny in Hun Sen's regime. Like many cases of independent reporters in Cambodia, Cambodians themselves, Cambodian reporters and editors who have been shot and bludgeoned to death, the case of Nate and Carol, this whole incident has been shrugged off officially as being called a robbery attempt. This legislation was amended after my staff spent long hours in discussion with the State Department in an effort to find a common position to stopping the violence and to bringing to justice those responsible. The amendment begins with the year 1979, when the Vietnamese Communist Army installed collaborating Khmer Rouge officers, including Hun Sen, to power in Cambodia. The amendment is an effort to avoid interfering with the State Department's efforts to form a separate tribunal to cover just the Pol Pot years. After the resolution passed through the International Relations Committee, I would ask for an additional 2 minutes.
Speaker, I have no objection to yielding the gentleman two additional.
Gentleman's recognized.
After this resolution passed through the International Relations Committee, Hun Sen protested. In response, the U.S. Embassy in Phnom Penh issued a press release just a few days ago to reassure this tyrant and his thugs that this resolution is simply the opinion of Congress, a signal that he need not worry about his ongoing human rights violations and crackdown on Democrats. Satisfied with knowing the embassy was kowtowing to his position, a now confident Hun Sen then demanded, after this press release, demanded that the embassy hand over a Cambodian democracy leader, Khem Sokha, who is being provided asylum in the embassy. A yes vote on this resolution will send a message to Hun Sen that the United States House of Representatives does count, and that we are speaking for the American people, and that the House of Representatives will not tolerate murder as a political tool and the denial of democracy by Hun Sen and his thugs. Madam Speaker, dictators such as Hun Sen must understand the United States Congress, whose members are elected by the American people, represent the ideals of freedom, and stand by Democrats and ordinary people around the world who are struggling for justice and human rights. There is no excuse for unelected bureaucrats in our State Department to scorn congressional processes in order to appease dictators. As far as tribunals go, We must not permit legal action in Cambodia, which is moving forward, to focus exclusively on a handful of geriatric Khmer Rouge leaders, while former Khmer Rouge like Hun Sen are creating today's killing fields by murdering and torturing with impunity. Today's killers must understand they will be held accountable for their actions, and they must permit democracy and a respect for human rights and the rule of law to take place. That's what this legislation is all about. And I would ask my colleagues to join me in support of this resolution.
Gentleman's time has expired. The gentleman from Florida.
Yield back the balance of my time, Madam.
Gentleman yields back the balance of his time. The gentleman from New York.
Madam Speaker, I want to thank the gentleman from California, Mr. Raubacher, for his eloquent support of this resolution. I'm pleased to yield 3 minutes to the distinguished vice chairman of our committee and the chairman of the subcommittee on Asian Pacific, the gentleman from Nebraska, Mr. Beamer.
The gentleman from Nebraska is recognized for 3 minutes.
Madam Speaker, I rise in strong support of H.R.E.S. 533, and I thank the chairman for this time. This resolution, of course, addresses the precarious human rights situation in Cambodia and the brutish behavior of the illegal junta in Cambodia and its strongman, Hun Sen. I use that term, illegal junta, advisedly. The gentleman from California, Mr. Raubacher, is to be particularly commended for this legislation and also for his continued focus on Cambodian affairs. Without question, the people of Cambodia have suffered enormously in the past few decades, almost beyond human understanding. They've suffered through colonial rule, civil war, the genocidal horror of Pol Pot, the Khmer Rouge, and then the Vietnamese invasion. Prolonged negotiations among the various political factions finally led to the Paris Peace Accords of 1991. The $3 billion international peacekeeping effort resulted in elections in 1993 where 90% of the population voted. Though the 1993 elections soundly rejected strongman Hun Sen and his formerly communist Cambodian party's CPP, Hun Sen simply refused to turn over the reins of power to the victorious Phuntsapek party. a tortuous and largely unsuccessful power-sharing arrangement with Hunsapek's leader, Prince Ranared, lasted until July of 1997, when a bloody coup d'etat ousted first Prime Minister Ranared and his supporters. Hun Sen's 1997 coup dealt a body blow to the fragile democratic institutions, which slowly had been taking root in the long-suffering country. In the weeks and months that followed, nearly all political activity except that of Hun Sen's CPP came to a halt. Most prominent opposition politicians, including Prince Ranared, fled for their lives into exile. Of those who chose to remain or were too slow in fleeing, many were murdered. On July 26th of this year, the long-awaited election was held, but this has done little to effectively resolve the long-standing differences or to restore credibility to the governance of the Cambodian people. The party of Hun Sen seems almost certain to continue to hold the reins of power, and opposition parties will continue to be marginalized. Madam Speaker, this is a situation where there are no simple answers and no clear blacks and whites. However, one constant thread has continued throughout this sordid mess. That is the appalling behavior of Hun Sen. His forces have been responsible for the summary arrest, torture, and murder of hundreds of opposition leaders. He has done everything in his power, including the 1997 coup, which is exactly what it was, despite the fact that the State Department never called it that because they knew it would result in kind of sanctions being imposed under law, to prevent the will of the people from being reflected in their properly elected leaders. These concerns and others are reflected in H.Res. 533, which highlights the human rights violations which have been perpetrated by the Hun Sen regime. This member would say that the author of the resolution, distinguished gentleman from California, Mr. Rohrabacher, has worked very constructively with others interested in the fate of Cambodia to ensure that his resolution, Mr. Chairman, may have an additional 1 minute.
I'm pleased to yield additional minute.
Gentlemen's recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. To ensure that this resolution has the broadest support possible, the gentleman has crafted a resolution that merits broad support. The gentleman has mentioned before what has happened with respect to the State Department and our embassy in Cambodia. And I am concerned about what he said. And unfortunately, I have some verification of it, too. In fact, my office was contacted suggesting that the embassy would no longer be able to protect Americans or the personnel at our embassy in Cambodia if this resolution was brought to the floor of the House of Representatives. We cannot be intimidated in this body. We cannot start down that slippery slope. The members will not permit that kind of thing to happen. And I would say that kind of threat by Hun Sen or people who represent him only confirm what he is, a bloody murderer. And we will not be silenced. And so I want my colleagues to know this is a resolution which is appropriate to express our concerns about the terrible things that have happened and that continue to happen under Hun Sen. Madam Speaker, I urge support of H.Res. 533. And I yield back the balance.
Gentleman's time has expired. Gentleman from New York.
Madam Speaker, how much time do we have remaining?
Gentleman has 5 1/2 minutes remaining.
Madam Speaker, I'm pleased to yield the balance of our time to the gentleman from New Jersey, the distinguished chairman of the Subcommittee on International Operations and Human Rights, Mr. Smith.
Gentleman from New Jersey is recognized for 5 1/2 minutes.
I thank the distinguished chairman for yielding. Mr. Speaker, Madam Speaker, I rise in strong support of this resolution and express my very deep gratitude to Mr. Rohrabacher for authoring it and for helping to bring it to the floor today, and to Chairman Bierreiter for his strong support for it, but also for helping to bring it as well, and Mr. Gilman, and for their very powerful words that they've expressed on this floor, and to my friends on the other side of the aisle. Mr. Speaker, the self-styled international community has displayed an unseemly haste in trying to persuade the pro-democracy parties in Cambodia, which between them soundly defeated the Hun Sen dictator in the recent election, despite the regime's attempt to intimidate voters and to silence the opposition. They've tried to get them to fold their tents and just slink away into oblivion. But to their credit, the democratic opposition has refused to give up. This is because they know that Hun Sen and his government all too well. They know that he is a monster. As Mr. B. Ryder pointed out a moment ago, he's bloodthirsty. He kills. They know that as a Khmer Rouge commander who split with Pol Pot, he did it not out of some moral principle, but he did it in a factional political and power struggle. They know that he has killed many of his political opponents, probably by the thousands, and will kill more if he is given the opportunity. And they know that the only hope for Cambodia is for the forces of freedom and democracy to hold on as long as they can. This resolution comes at a very timely time, will give them some hope. Yes, maybe a small and modest amount of hope, but it will give them some hope that those of us in the international community, those of us in the People's House, know what's going on, and we stand in solidarity with those pro-democratic forces. It's a very good resolution, and I hope it has the unanimous support of the House of Representatives. And again, I want to thank Mr. B. Ryder, Mr. Rohrbacher, and Mr. Gilman for their leadership in bringing this to the floor. I yield back to Mr. Gilman the balance of time.
Gentleman yields back. Gentleman from New York.
Madam Speaker, we have no further requests for time. I yield back the balance of my time.
Gentleman yields back. Question is, will the House suspend the rules and agree to House Resolution 533 as amended? So many as are in favor say aye. Those opposed, no. In the opinion of the chair, two-thirds of those present having voted in the affirmative, the rules are suspended. The resolution is agreed to, and without objection, the motion to reconsider is laid on the table. Without objection.